Welcome to Albany County Fasteners, Fasteners 101. Today we're going to talk about gauges, different types of gauges. So let's get started. So today I'm going to teach you about gauges. We have numerous gauges for measuring many different types of fasteners. So I'll start off with the rivet gauge. This is a rivet gauge. It's made for measuring the diameter of a rivet along with the number or the length of a rivet. And that'll give you the grip length for the rivet. So here I have a rivet. I'm going to find what size it is. It's not a 5. So this is a number 6. And the length is a 64. So you find the diameter, you find the length, the slot that it fits into. See these it doesn't fit into. So the slot, and then right to the bottom where the ball is, that's your length. So you don't measure a rivet like that. That's totally incorrect. You can't measure it like that. It has to be measured by the hat to the size number. The next gauge we have is a Imperial metric gauge. This gauge will allow you to measure, this is quarter 20. So here, down here, they have anywhere from a number 4 all the way up to 1-inch bolt you can slide in here. On this side, so half of the gauge has Imperial, which is this side here, and the other half of the gauge is metric. So to measure this hex cap screw, I would go to look what hole it was slide in. Snugly, and we can see it fits in the quarter 20. This is the 5/16. It's too big. It's just slopping around in there. So we know that it's a quarter. And then to measure the length, because hex cap screws are measured from under the head, so we would measure it from this side. This has two measuring points. I'm sorry, it would be this side. We have two measuring points. This little angle cut in here is made for a flathead, and this side is made for the length, okay, from under the head. So in this situation, we would see that this is 7/8 of an inch when all said and done. This is 1 inch, and it's 1/8 less, so we have 7/8 of an inch. So we know it's 1/4 inch by 7/8, okay, but we don't know. This gauge will not tell you what the thread is. Is it fine thread? Is it coarse thread? This gauge is not able to tell you that. We have this other gauge that will tell you that. This is another gauge where you can measure or find out what type of thread you have. And this is a metric. The metric goes from an M4 all the way up to M12. This also includes coarse, fine, and some super fine lengths. You can see it's on a wire here. I have one that's in here that you can go to each one of these until it fits. And then you can find out at that point what thread you have along with the size. Because on here, it'll tell you that this is an M6 by 1.0. So you have an M6 by 1.0 thread pitch. So that's all for metric. We have another thread gauge. This is for Imperial sizes. This is like perfect for your shop. You gotta have it. Here's a nut. This is half. half 13, okay? Put the nut on, you can find what size that this will fit on. This is half 20, it doesn't work, it doesn't go on. So the half 13, we know that this is a half 13, along with a hex cap screw that I have in here that I'm unscrewing. You screw it back in. And that size, I believe, is quarter 20. So that's your Imperial set. They have these end loops so you can hang them on your toolboxes or connect them to your workbench or somewhere in your shop. These are great gauges to have. We use them here in our warehouse when we have mixed bins that we find where we have product mixed in the wrong bin. It's not something that we like to have, but unfortunately that does happen sometimes, and this gets us out of that bind. When you're measuring a flathead socket cap, a flathead sheet metal screw, or flathead wood screw, or a deck screw, this notch right here, that is made so you can get the length, okay? And the length of this, which includes the head, would be 2.5 inches long. And that's how you measure that with that gauge. The next gauge I have, which is basically a, this does metric and does imperial sizes. This is good for measuring many different ways. You can measure, has an on and off. It has the zero, so you can zero out in case when it's closed, you make sure that it's zeroed out. And it has millimeter and inches up here, so you can switch between millimeter and imperial size. So if I wanted to measure this flat washer, the inside, which I know that this is 1 inch, I believe, so it should be more than 1 inch, so a 1 inch bolt can fit in that. These two prongs on the outside measure inside circumference or inside diameter, and this measures out as 1.062. And now it just went to 1 point because I pulled it out. So it's possible if it's not totally straight in there because it's round, I'm trying to get a number, and that's a good way to make sure you got the right number. So 1.059, that's what it's coming up with, 1.059. I don't know if you can see that, but that's the inside, and that's fine because if you're putting a 1 inch bolt into this, you need that extra room for the bolt to fit in there properly. You can also measure with the caliper an outside diameter, okay, which will say that the outside of this washer is 2.014 inches, so it's just over 1 inch, and you can measure the thickness, so that's 0.1175. So this is a very handy tool to have. You can do many different things with it. If you had to measure an inside, a let's just take something, let's just say you want to measure inside this area, you can take this end piece here, which is a ruler basically, and you can push it in there, and then you can push it down, and you know the depth. That's 0.447 from the top to the bottom of the inside. So there's many, many uses for this caliper. We use it in our office all the time. These are Great gauges to have at your fingertips whenever you're using or working on your projects. You'll find all the answers. These are the old-fashioned type right here, which are pieces of paper that you put your washers on, or you line your nut, your screw on, or your nut on, and you try to find out which side, which size it is, what it is. I mean, you know, this is old stuff. I don't know why we're even bothering with that stuff today. You gotta get rid of that. This is what you need. This is what you gotta get. So I've showed you the gauges. These gauges are available on our website, and put them right to work. You'll definitely use them and you'll need them. There you go. Subscribe, like, comment. Visit us at albanycountyfasteners.com for 50,000 SKUs right off the rack, ready to ship. We look forward to seeing you in our next video.